Afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Sunday Sessions with Courtenay Pollock. Hi, Courtenay.
Hi, Heidi.
So I'm behind the camera today, and we're going to do something a little bit different. You know, we're now here in Powell River, where his stories has landed, and we're going to be talking more about his craft and his artwork and what he's been really focusing on for the past 18 years or so.
Yeah, 17, 18 years here in Powell River.
Exactly. And bringing it to people through online, correct?
Wow. Hey, the social media. A blessing in disguise, or a, you know, a devil in the disguise.
No doubt. So, Courtenay, let's start with, you know, the initial process.
Okay. So what I thought I'd do, there are other stories, you know, that'll come along, but we haven't really gone through, you know, my method, the process that I came up with back in the 60s when I first saw tie-dye and I wanted to, you know, figure out how I would do it. And I'd only seen, you know, kind of random swirling colors and stuff like that, but I, as a kid, I loved working with colors. So, I thought, well, if I want to make a circle, you know, you fold it in quarters and then in eighths and then, you know, tie off bands and you have consecutive radiating circles, you know, and you can put anything you want in those intervals between them. And that came to me in a millisecond, you know, and I went, well, I can apply that to all kinds of folding geometry. So that's the principle of what I do. So without further ado, I'm going to demonstrate a really quick and very simple mandala with a few scarabs so that you can see how it works. And then we'll move over to the die shelf where I have my die set up, and we'll demonstrate, you know, dipping some of the scarabs. And then we're going to move to a big 8-foot mandala that I have already tied and dyed, and we're going to open it. It's a big expose. I won't have seen this yet. You'll be seeing it same
for the first time
I do, right? Well, fantastic. Not quite the same time because it might be a week lag. Anyway, and then we'll hang it up.
So
do the best I can. Hopefully, you know, this is still entertaining. I hope any of it's been entertaining, or all of it. So here we go.
All right.
With time.
Okay, here we go.
So I'm starting off. I've got a square of cloth. I fold it in half and then half again. And for a simple, so the center is here. So for a simple mandala, we're folding it into, you know, it's in quarters, and now it's eighths, and now it's like into, you know, 16ths. So do the other side, same thing, just I'm going very quickly through this. This is, you know, I take a little more care when I'm actually preparing a piece, but for the sake of our demonstration, I'll just kind of quickly and, you know, rather crudely go through it. And I'm making this as simple as possible. So it's in half, half again, and then you fold it twice more for each half. And now,
It's okay. I was getting all close.
I just put an elbow in the camera. So here's the center again, of course, and we're going to make a little, we want to have these little folds in here because they are all part of the design. And now I'm going to, this is the center, as I said, we're going to make a little a little fold into the center, and right there where the point is, I'm going to just make a little V right in that little center, kind of like a little wedge, like a little diamond. And then I'm going to fold that in to, and make these cells. And these, I call them cells because they're essentially tied off individually from the rest of the piece so that I can fill them with dye individually. And now, as I said, this is a very simple demonstration that can be kind of, you know, enlarged, elaborated upon. This is a very basic for a simple mandala, which is, you know, circle radiating from the center. And now I want to, we could make this more complex by making another layer, but for these purposes of demonstration, we're not going to do that. I'm going to section off this piece and have these crinkles and folds come in like there. And this is the outside. I'm just going to make a simple fold that in to make its own cell, if you like. And this all looks very simple and basic. Essentially, it is. Of course, I've been doing it for 50 plus years, so it might look a little simpler for me than it does for you, but it's still, you know, it's pretty basic. This is probably the, you know, the least complicated design that would include scarabs, because I know a lot of people really want to know, how do you do the scarabs? Okay, here we go. Here's the scarabs. I'm going to do, see, we have these pleats, right? This is the center line right here. This is the center fold right here. And so these are the other. Now, for the purpose, I could separate each of these folds and do a scarab, but for the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to put these four pleats together and make a scarab. And here we go. So, about equidistant from the two tie points, I'm making a, you can see how that goes. Off. I don't have three hands, so I use my teeth. And okay, Ruby. Oh gosh, Ruby. She must have seen. Oh yeah,
Ruby.
The neighbor's going down to the beach. Boo. Okay, Ruby. Now. Sorry about the Ruby. The sound effects. Always be careful not to snip the cloth. You know, once that's done, your piece is done, screwed. So always tie a bow, never, you know, make a knot. Anything that you have to cut, eventually you will cut the cloth and you've screwed your piece up. So, you know, in all the decades of doing this, only once have I actually snipped a cloth. And it was in a big mandala right at the center. And I patched it. Nobody noticed. I donated it to the Cranberry Arts Center, where, you know, as a backdrop for shows and music venues and stuff like that. So here we are, there's another little scarab. I'm making little segments to fill with dye. And since my method is like I tie this up into a bundle, you know. You may have little points sticking out like this, and essentially it's just a vessel with all this geometry folded in. And and then I fill each cell up, or each scarab, with, you know, an array of colors. Once you have, oh dear, it fell off the edge. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I'm hurrying. One more to do. Takes a little bit of dexterity and a little bit of you know, hand strength, which you can develop. I mean, you can't expect to be, you know, perfect straight out the gate, but some people are.
You've had some people that have apprenticed under you that have taken off with the craft, haven't
you? Yeah, they were apprenticed only because they were actually my assistants. So, mm-hmm. you know, they were working with me. I don't just teach people how to do it for nothing. But in the case of the people that were my assistants...
Yeah.
Over the years, I gave them the option to learn how to do it, and most of those that were interested did an amazing job. You know, their results, they came out like a pro. So I can tell you right now that you know, you too can do this. So here's the three scarabs. Now this loose stuff around here, I need to tighten it up. So I'm actually going to, as long as I can get these scarabs and separate them to fill them up with their various colors, I'm going to, I'm good to tie this up and tighten this cloth, because you don't want dye running out of loose cloth. And now the setting agent for the procyon dyes is soda ash. And so you make a soda ash solution, which I have already have one. And we're going to just sit this in the soda ash solution, let the soda ash absorb. I don't want to get these hanging in the dye and then coming out dripping with dye. You know, put it in places on the cloth that I don't want them. So anyway, there we are. That's a very basic, very simple, crude demonstration of tying a simple mandala with a simple row of scarabs of only three different colors of scarab. So... we put them in the soda ash, and it'll just sink to the bottom and absorb.
So this will sink to the bottom and absorb all the soda ash.
And then once it's absorbed, I'll just take it out and spin it. Spin the excess moisture out. So now I did a duplicate before this. I have an exact same little thing tied up, already soaked and spun out. So we don't have to wait for that. And I can go right into demonstrating the dyeing. And I have my dyes already mixed. And of course, this is fun because it's colors. So what we're going to do is I'll start with like the center scarab. And I want to expose it so that I can dip it without other parts of it getting in any other colors, right? So here we go. I'm going to start with this like little blue that's got a slight turquoise blush to it. Go into that purple and then go into this beautiful fuchsia and then the Chinese red and then into this golden yellow, which is blushing out the outside. And then we go to the next scarab. I make it, this looks very simple, but it, when you come to do it, it's not quite as simple, but here we go with the gold. Mm-hmm. See, that fills up that there. Now that point is full of liquid. You can't, you know, if I pushed it, it'll blush up from this blue. It'll push the gold up and it'll make a green. But if you go into, like, say, the green, I go a little deeper than the gold, and now the gold is still contained in that tip. And the, and the, so, and then go into a dark blue, and now I'm going to go into a purple. And the paper towel is just to dab it so that you don't have stuff dripping all over on itself. And then I'm going to have, let's see, a little gold, the fuchsia, some purple, the mid blue. And now we have the three scarabs dyed. See the little blot on there. And let's say this is our center is right in here. So I'm going to go into the Chinese red. That's the fuchsia. I'm going to give it the golden yellow. And another touch of fuchsia, because I'm going to go into the gold and I want to have that little bit of fuchsia behind it. And then I'm going into this medium blue that has a turquoise blush to it. And that'll combine with that gold, make a little bit of greenish. And now I have this little collar here, and I'm going to go into the gold with it. And so there we are so far. This is the outside, the field of the piece. So let's have a kind of a dark field. There's the dark blue, there's the purple, that's the black. Let's go a bit of the dark green and then into the dark blue and then into the purple. And let's see, let's go into the black. And this is the gold again. This is a bit of a... Now this is essentially filled with dye, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm going to go really quickly all the way down and have this collar around it in the gold. And then dye off this, fill with dye this section in the black. And there we are. So what I do now is to wrap it in a little piece of tin foil just to contain the moisture and while it sets up. Typically takes 3 or 4 hours at room temperature for the guys to set. But so there's that. So far so good. Now what we're going to do, I dyed a big full-size mandala that I tied yesterday, and I'm going to dye, I dyed it this morning in order to demonstrate the unveiling, you know, and for that moment, I won't be talking because it's just kind of like, you know, it takes a little while, about, you know, 5 or 10 minutes to unveil it, and then we'll hang it up on the wall and you'll see the whole thing exposed. So meanwhile, I'm going to put on a song. Walter Martella, who's a wonderful jazz pianist and a director of the Music Academy in town, he and I put together a little album of just piano and voice. So I'm going to put on one of my, you know, some songs.
Excellent.
and then we'll unveil the my sound system is a little slow to react. Oh, come on. Just when I need it to cooperate, it's not cooperating.
We'll pan over to Ruby.
Yeah.
Hi, Ruby. Hey. And it's a gorgeous day here in Powell River. Sun is shining. The eagles are screaming. I can't get the door open.
Oh, that's not right. That is not what I want. Oh my God. Oh,
what do you think, Ruby?
You're listening to 103.5 FM. That's WCLM.
No. LPFM,
Chapel Hill, Carver.
I'm sorry, this is just screwing everything up.
That's okay. Chapel Hill, Carver, to get it correct.
I can't.
How about press pause?
Listening to New Grass Revival in the background.
Nothing's working.
All right, are you ready?
No.
Okay.
It's time for a little wow in your life. You are tuned in to wow. Find out more at
Screwing up our tape.
That's okay.
Sorry.
It's all right. You know what we'll do? We're at 20 minutes. So we'll do...
There we are.
Oh, okay. Here we go.
Right.
Ooh, it's loud.
Angel eyes. I'll start by taking off
the ties.
Some of the ties, so that I can expose things a little better.
Mm-hmm.
That old devil sent. Need I say that my life's misspent with angel eyes tonight?
So drink up, all you people, or anything you see.
Have fun, you happy people, for the drinks and the laughs are on me.
So this is, so it's still wet, hey?
This is, yeah, it's, you can see it's spewing dye.
Got a friend that's now number one. And why my angel eyes ain't here.
Boy. now I can kind of get to the sections. I'm gonna remove the little caps that kept the things pristine, protected from each other. And
I always wondered how you kept it from like not bleeding into one another.
Right. So drink up, all you people. So now I'm gonna free up these sections.
Mm-hmm.
Have fun, you happy people. For the drinks and the laughs are on me. Follow me, could I gotta run?
The facts are comfortably clear.
Who I find who's now number one, and why my angel eyes ain't here. Okay, and now we're gonna undo the little scarabs. Excuse me while I disappear. You haven't seen this either, have you?
I haven't, no. This is pretty amazing. Very nice.
In the quiet, silent second sight, I turned off the light switch and I came down to meet you in the half-light the moon left for
love. Through nature sang some songs out of tune.
And a mantle of bright light shone down
from her room. Come down in time.
I still hear her say, so clear in my ear.
This is an Elton John song.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Come down in time.
What's the best hand she gave to me? Come down in time, and I'll meet you halfway.
So you see, I'm doing rows so they don't get too busy. They have, they're not exactly the same, but they're similar enough so that they're lines of, you know, basically green scarabs.
Yeah.
A little variation.
Yeah.
Some of them open easier than others.
Yeah.
They're just bows, but I got the sun shining in and I'm shadowing what I'm doing by my hand, so I can't really see the strings very well.
Do you want me to come in the other side?
No, it's fine.
You're good?
We're closing in on it.
Alright.
Stars in the night. This has got a field of black mostly. Yeah. I did it to showcase the scarabs.
Mm-hmm.
And the center's got, you know, colors in there.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, it makes great contrast. And then you can kind of see where everything is and kind of how it's done.
Yeah.
Upon the fields of barley, and the mountain fell as our hair came down. Among the fields of gold. Okay, there's that part. Now we're going to rinse it. And I'll open it up a little bit.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Right? That is beautiful.
On the fields of body, your heart body rise when you kiss her mouth. Among the fields of gold. Typically, I would wear an apron.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I would advise anybody working with dyes to wear an apron. Wear gloves, of course. And, We'll walk in fields of gold. So there's a lot of excess dye, but it's cold water.
So it won't run.
You can see, you know, it's losing color fast.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to go into a second sink and rinse again, and then I'll fill this basin up and give another rinse. Fields of gold. Lots of color. So much lighter. Thought that I'd see you again. Still a lot of color coming out. Colors are still bright. It's lost a lot of its excess dye. Color. But I always thought that I'd see you again. I can just see through the water to the bottom of the sink, which means that there's not a lot of dye still coming out. So maybe one more sink is, that'll do it. so almost clear. Laborious. the border pressure is really, really poor. So awfully hot in our fur coat.
Yes.
I mean, definitely a winter coat, because, you know,
yes,
we can trim it in the summer, but it's still really a big coat. Okay. I could keep rinsing, but it doesn't really matter at this point. There's very little coming out, and it's not a piece of going to get laundered, so I can, at this point, I just spin out the excess water and then we'll hang it up.
All right, right? Perfect.
Wait a few minutes for the spinner and then we'll hang it up and we'll see what we got.
Okay.
So just to recap, tie the piece up and you can put your own ingenuity in or your own geometry, anything, you know, make it tight enough, not totally tight, but tight enough so that it doesn't have dye fluid running through it. You want to contain those bands of color so they don't move, and you fill it up, let it set. And takes, you know, 4 hours or overnight at room temperature, and then rinse it out, spin it out to get all that excess water out, and then you can hang it up to dry. So that's where we're at. And as I said, I dyed that big mandala that we're gonna see in a minute this morning. And so anyway, here we are. I'm filling time for the spinner to finish. I mean, this is a little scrappy video, But it's still, you know, hopefully it'll, you get something from it.
Get the ideas.
Yeah.
So, tell me a little bit about the colors. Why do you work with these colors?
Typically, I have, I've only got 9 right here. Sometimes I'll have more, 12 maybe. But black, navy, blue, mid blue, green, brown, gold, red, fuchsia, and purple. I need a turquoise, but I ran out of turquoise. I didn't realize it didn't come in on the last order. And maybe another purple. So I've got a good array of color. That's essentially, and you know, I dye them, I mix them pretty strong.
Mm-hmm.
And I mix the soda ash 10 times strength, what they
So what
suggest.
Is soda ash?
It's like washing soda.
Oh.
Wait.
Okay, so it's like baking soda? Or like...
It's not baking soda, it's...
like laundry
it's,
detergent?
It's sodium... sodium chloride? What? Sodium sulfate.
Ah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So anyway, that's the setting agent. So because my method is different from standard tea dye, I don't do it, you know, soaked in the soda ash. I soak, saturate it, spin out as much as it'll spin out. Now it's like, kind of, it's more than damp, wet.
Yeah.
But it's got enough soda ash in there, because I put so much soda ash in the concentrate, to, when it gets filled with dyes, that soda ash will, you know, activate the dyes and set them.
Right.
So that's kind of how that works.
Okay.
And, so, I think it's still spinning.
So the collaboration of music that you have going on in the background was with Walter
Montella.
Yeah.
Who's a wonderful friend, and he's the director of the Academy for the last 5 years.
Here in Powell River?
Here in Powell River. The Academy was instituted, put together, and developed by Don James.
Yeah.
And he retired about 5 years ago, and Walter, who was his protege, he brought him along since he was a kid.
Aww.
And Walter's taken over, and he's doing a great job. He's got a wonderful sense of humor, and he's so comfortable with audiences. And of course, he's an amazing pianist and trumpet player, accordion player. I think he's currently learning other instruments.
Oh, wow, he's super talented.
He's so talented. Of course, he's a wonderful chorister, and he is the director of all our choirs. Through the choirs, you know, my singing experience really developed. Choir work is not easy, you know, and you practice and practice. And for me, I sing in the first tenor. Section, so you know, it's there's some pretty high highs, you know, but I can also sing low because I'm a natural baritone. But it really develops your voice, you know, your ability, your pitch. You've either got it or you don't, really.
Yeah.
But you know, the ability to hit pitch, you know, is a matter of having all the muscles working right. So anyway, so we put this little album together of these, you know, lovely songs. And I just put it on so there's not these blank pauses in the background while I'm rinsing and stuff.
Yeah.
Now it's like it's a bit loud, eh?
It is loud.
Anyway, I'm going to take the piece out of the dryer now. It should be ready to hang up.
Okay.
And so here we go.
All right.
Hopefully.
I'm following you.
It's done.
I'm following you.
It's done.
Yes. And there's Ruby, his trustful helper.
She's right on point.
Yes.
thought of you made my heart sing like an April breeze on the wings of spring. And you appear in all your splendor, my one and only love. The shadows fall and spread their mystic charms in the hush of night while you're in my arm. I feel your lips so warm and tender, my one and only love. The touch of your hand is like heaven, a heaven that I've never known. The blush on your cheek whenever I speak tells me that you are my own. You fill my eager heart with such desire. Every kiss you give sets my soul on fire. I give myself in sweet surrender, my one and only
So you can see those colors that just pop.
They really pop as a black.
Touch of your
hand is like heaven.
Turn this down.
A heaven that I've never known. And the blush on your cheek whenever I speak tells me that you are my own.
All right. Well, it's beautiful, Courtenay.
Thank you.
And yeah, I hope everyone's enjoyed this process. And
mine got better up the other way, but you know, I can just
flip it upside down.
I can flip it upside down.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Ta-da!
Thanks, Courtenay. We hope you enjoyed this episode, and maybe we'll do some more of this creative stuff.
Right.
Have a good one, everybody. Thanks for joining. Bye.